Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of The Witness. Now, let's take another look at this and see if we can find anything on our way to the top of the mountain, because that's where we're going next. Are you excited? I'm excited. We haven't been up there. We've seen it, but we haven't been up there. But let's see if we can find these shapes along the way. I think these were like our flower arrangements over there. So if this is to the right of the flower arrangements, that kind of puts it in this... Let's see, where does it put us? Does it put us down here in the rocky area? Maybe it's in this lake? You know, I'm not really sure. You know, I haven't been over here like this. I haven't been down here either. Or I could have just crossed the bridge here. I mean, that would have been fine too. And there's gotta be something... There's gotta be something interesting about this lake that we haven't found yet. It's a little strange. Or maybe it's like the one place that is untouched by the crazy laws of man. That could be it! Or maybe I'm just crazy. But I feel like it's not in that village. I feel like it has to be this bridge. So let's take a trip up here. I guess this is our favorite building in the world because we come up here about a million times. No hyperbole, of course. We'll make our way to the top of the mountain. Don't worry about it. I promise to start the climb before the end of the episode. I don't know how long it might take us to get to the top of the mountain. I don't know if there's any obstacles in our way or not. Here's what I was looking for. And that goes exactly where I wanted it to. Alright, so that's good. That means we are actually absolutely 100% correct about how that works. Which makes things a little strange. I mean, strange, actually, maybe not strange. Maybe strange is the wrong word to be using, but... It makes things seem much less random. Which is a positive thing. It's absolutely a positive thing. I don't see anything else from up here, though. We already got that down there. Alright, back down to the bottom. This is a very strange tower to climb. I'll be happy if I never have to climb it again. Alright. Maybe it's these flowers. No, it was a relatively straight line. So that's kind of what we need to look for, is a relatively straight line. I have not been back here. In this little area. I mean, I guess it's not relevant. We're finding that out right now. Where's this? This looks like... Okay, I think I know where that is. Wherever it is, it's not important because it's back here. Yay! Alright, so... We'll find it eventually. But we're probably not gonna... We're not gonna keep looking... We're not going to look too hard today. If we don't find it now, it's fine. There will absolutely be more opportunities to find environmental puzzles. I feel like it has something to do with this. But maybe not, because it doesn't look like there's an endpoint here. All right, let's just keep on going. Make our way to the mountaintop. I'm really excited, by the way. We've been building this up for quite a while. Also, I'm getting distracted by this painter up here. How you doing, lady? Look at her. She's so happy, so peaceful. She hasn't gotten started yet, but that's okay. You take your time. When the inspiration strikes, that's when you strike. Strike the inspiration right back. I feel like this would be a very, very difficult picture to paint by hand, actually. All the colors, all the intricate... Am I in your way? No, I'm not. Good. All the strands of grass, all the weepy willow trees. Plus that. This game is just breathtaking. I love it. I love it. All right, enough. Enough talking to the painter lady. Let's climb. And let's take a look at this obelisk while we climb. There are about a million things here that we haven't even started to solve. Where was this? Good God. I believe these are in the swamp. Wow, we have so many things to find in the swamp. That's scary, or maybe they're up the mountain. Whatever, we're gonna go up the mountain. We're not scared of no environmental puzzle. We're not scared of nothing. We doesn't afraid of anything. If you're gonna allow me to meme out a little bit. Wait a minute. Does that light something? That lights nothing. Alright, looks like we gotta go all the way back down here to make our way up the mountain. I don't know how many episodes it's been since we've tried to come up here, but... Oh, man. It looks like if that was just a little higher, I would be able to... Maybe not. Maybe not. So there was kind of a little... little something down here that I kind of maybe thought I saw in my videos. It doesn't look like it really takes me anywhere, though. Just kind of a nice little look around. Just gotta be as clever as I can be to find anything that I could possibly find. But we're just gonna go up the mountain. Not get distracted by going down the mountain. We climb a tree. This is dangerous. Oh no. Oh no. Oh! What? They're everywhere. Here we go. Whoever the gardener is for this situation, they deserve a raise. They deserve a raise. That's all there is to it. Maybe we do it from up there. We are on the lady's hand. There's her nose. It's a very nice nose. This is... cool. I mean, there could be a circle anywhere. Could be anything. It could be hiding in plain sight. In fact, it probably is. There's probably one right there that I'm failing to see. It's just a matter of finding the right spot to stand. You know, it really makes me wonder how they program all this in. Like, there could be just like small little triggers that once you stand in them, It gives you the prompt. Whoa, is the color changing up here? The color just changed on me. What the fuck? It's not cool. Can't change colors on me. I don't know how I feel about this. What is that? There's a path. Come down here. That's dangerous. There's a path down here. You don't need to do this stuff. You don't need to prove to me that you're strong. I'll go back down to that water circle later. It is eerily quiet up here. Okay, now there's the wind. I was wondering when the wind would kick in. Oh, come on. Is it in the clouds now? It's almost in the clouds. Oh. You know, I don't like heights. Is this snow? I don't like heights. This has given me a little bit of the chills. Okay, that went to that one. Oh. What a sight. This island is absolutely gorgeous. The wind's freaking me out, I'm not gonna lie. The howling winds. Also, that tree, man. Like, what if I do something up here and it completely changes the landscape. It morphs everything into a completely new configuration that we never saw coming. We never expected, we never suspected. Even though we always respected. Can I hit that windmill from up here? Nope. Wait a minute, there was a cloud thing. I'm creating so much suspense. There was some cloud configuration that I was worried about that looked like it was going to turn into something. I swear there's cloud circles that we need to trace. There's no way there's not. There's gotta be. Good job, photographer. You are doing the right thing, photographing this. What does this do? This opens a big one. I wanna see all these statues first. Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa. He's on a cliff, lady! Don't berate him while he's on a cliff! Look, he's got a Bible to his heart and everything. He's praying for the safety of his own life, and you are shouting at him! Look at that face! Look at that face! Look at that face! Look, thank you, Beard Bros, for that song. I love that song. Look at That Face by Alex Fassiani and, Gerard Dragon Rider Khalil. But look at that face. She's so angry at him. And this guy has a laptop. And he's so upset because he probably doesn't get Wi-Fi up here. I would be upset too. Oh, he's got a suitcase? What's this guy doing? Don't hit this. Why are you angry? No, he's just working real hard. He's very strong. Look at that physique. Look at him. He's cut. He's cut like stone. I regret nothing. Also, what's happening to this guy? Is he dead? No, he's just super exhausted. Also, the laptops kind of indicate that perhaps... Oh, what the... What does this do? That's this. Is this how they plan their things? Their shenanigans? Take one look at this guy. My people, we are almost completed. Moment of truth. I don't know if you guys realize, but you're kind of in the way. So I need to segregate the blacks and the whites. Does that count them as segregated? That ain't it. Oh, No, I cannot do that. I can do something like this. Oh, man. Because that's not separated from this guy. Start like this. I can come around. And then that actually does separate them. Oh, I need to hit every single one of these three latches. So different perspectives. So this was what? I stood here, which was approximately... It was close to 100 degrees off of where I stand. So if I stand 100 degrees off from what I need to target, will that give me a good starting position? It does not look like it. Let's stand here. This looks like it might give us something a little bit easier to handle. So we need to separate the whites and the blacks. Very simple puzzle. But what we have here is a little bit of a tizzy. Little bit of a tizzy, only a little bit. Perspective is ruining everything. Dude, don't tell me there's also stuff here on this. I don't know if I can handle that. I don't know if... Are you kidding me? I'm not ready for this life. This puzzle life. This is ridiculous. Also, there's a black one. There it is. Wait, there's a guy there. It's drawn on his butt. I'm gonna tickle his butt. Any more endpoints here? There were two white endpoints. From like right here. No, wait, it's from over here. There's another guy up there. Or lady. Looks, whoever it is, they're melting. Is that a scarf? Can we see the rock climber from up here? Yeah, there it is. I think that was a woman too. I can't tell. The long-haired ones are a little bit on the androgynous side. So it's hard to really tell. So let's see if we can... Wait a minute, this could be... something here? Maybe... Maybe not. We already got that one, we need... Can't cross the foot. Can I cross the foot yet? Yes, I can. So how about I come down here? I have no way back across. That doesn't solve anything. That just creates more problems. More problems, no solutions. cut these guys off from the world like so, but we cannot cross there.
Without being able to cross there, then what else do we have?
I don't know. I don't know what to do. It's literally... it throws a loop into every single plan that I've ever had. A wrench, even. Not even a loop. A wrench. A whole wrench. This might actually be... a solution to the side that we've already solved. You jerk. Ah. All right.
I get it. I don't get it.
No, that's not it.
So,
I'll... okay, we come across here. Cuts that off. But we can't cut these guys off from each other. If I do this, I can come around here. Cuts that off perfectly fine.
So I think we need to start here. I think I might be on to nothing. Okay, this is something I haven't tried yet. All right, so there was that one, and this last one will be very tricky. Maybe we have to... what if we stand here? Do we find anything clever? I can't even see the circle there. It's not even gonna let me move from it. If I come around, there's no way back. Wait a minute, is this right? Oh, I need to be able to see. Okay, what about... I'm almost there. I can feel it. I can feel it in my bones. If I come around this way, and then I cut off on that corner there... going down. Going down. What the? Whoa. Are these cameras? Why is it moving? Where is this? Still have not opened that door, by the way. We still haven't solved the bottom of that puzzle. That looks like it might be the inside of the building that went all the way down to the bottom, where it made us solve the sound puzzle without sound. And this is the top of the village. That's wrong. That's totally wrong. I have that opened. Thank you. How dare you think that I'm slacking. Down into the depths. What the f- oh, what are we looking into? No. No. You tell me what we're looking into. That looks like outside. What? Getting a little Truman Show in here. Gonna make me solve these from a distance. Oh, I can barely see that one. Do I have to solve these?
I feel ill.
Oh. Bridge of light. Bridge of light. Show me the way. Man. This went from, like, maybe sort of a little bit tiny-ish realistic in some way to what the shit is going on here. I am uncomfortable. Wait a minute, so we can come up like this. It's really disorienting to solve a puzzle like this. What? No, you're fine. That's four? That's four. Alright, I'm sorry I doubted you. So sorry. Friggin' diva. What? Oh.
Oh. I see. Doing this wrong. So I need to do come in like this. Or come in like this. But if I do this. Okay, this needs to this has to extend. I come in like this. Oh wait, I can still. No, but I can't bisect them. I can't split them in half. So I need to come up like this, right? But then I still need to separate that guy. Or I could just do this. And that separate. No, it doesn't. That does not separate them at all. What if I do something like this? Still, how do I get that one on the top? No. Let's go back. We solve this one first. This one that looks easy, even though we can't quite see all the elements of the puzzle in a very easy way. What are you doing to me, game? Boom. I solved you. You don't tell me what to do. You might. What is that? What is that inside of? Where is that? Why don't I recognize that? Oh! You okay? You okay, buddy? This is so strange. This weird white room. Truman shows, checkerboards, puzzles that we can't quite see. Oh, there's a black square there. What a jerk. White, black, okay. We have no way over there, so
No. Before we leave, we have to solve this one. It might be in the trash, but it's still there for a... It's the castle. It's still there for a reason. What is this place? Don't remember. Looks like it might be the color tower? This one confuses me. I don't know. I don't know what that one is. It looks like there's a circle there. Doesn't it? And then that. Alright, no, let's solve this real quick. We can do it. All we have to do is believe. You know, back up.
All we have to do is believe, and we can accomplish whatever we want. You got it? Yeah? You got it?
Good.
Now stop being a snot-nosed little brat. Solve the puzzle. Like you were taught.
I think I might be onto something with whatever I was doing here. Wait a minute, what am I doing here? What am I doing here?
I don't even know anymore. I don't even know what I'm doing here. Ever.
What was I thinking? Was I thinking something like this? Because that looks like it could work. No, because it can't, because those guys down there are upset at each other. But with a little bit of alteration, we can make them all happy. No, that they're not happy there either. Ooh. So maybe, just maybe, what we need... Ugh, jeez, is exact... I can't control it in here.
It's not exactly this. It's exactly not this.
If we do this... Come around like this... We can kind of change... Nothing. Because the black and white on top are not happy with each other. They're in a big argument. And they're screaming at one another about who owes how much rent. But if I come at this the other way... If I come at this the other way... Then I can't do shit. So let's see. This is what we were doing. Come back here. Those guys are angry at each other. I can't come in the other way. And I feel like it's got to be something along the lines of this. No, but then the black and white! Maybe it's something along the lines of this. Whoa, that did something. What did it do? Hey, an audio log.
The relation between the controller and the controlled is reciprocal. The scientist in the laboratory studying the behavior of a pigeon designs contingencies and observes their effects. His apparatus exerts a conspicuous control on the pigeon, but we must not overlook the control exerted by the pigeon. The behavior of the pigeon has determined the design of the apparatus and the procedures in which it is used. Some such reciprocal control is characteristic of all science. As Francis Bacon put it, nature, to be commanded, must be obeyed. The scientist who designs a cyclotron is under the control of the particles he is studying. The behavior with which a parent controls his child, either aversively or through positive reinforcement, is shaped and maintained by the child's responses. A psychotherapist changes the behavior of his patient in ways which have been shaped and maintained by his success in changing that behavior. A government or religion prescribes and imposes sanctions selected by their effectiveness in controlling citizen or communicant. An employer induces his employees to work industriously and carefully with wage systems determined by their effects on behavior. The classroom practices of the teacher are shaped and maintained by the effects on his students. In a very real sense, then, the slave controls the slave driver, the child, the parent, the patient, the therapist, the citizen, the government, the communicant, the priest, the employee, the employer, and the student, the teacher. B.F. Skinner, 1971.
Very interesting case study of sorts. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have plenty more to do. Much more than I anticipated. This is so freaking weird. I hope this reveal was as awesome for you as it was for me. I'm still kind of taken aback by all this white room inside of the mountain. It goes super deep. I don't know how far. There's also stuff on the island proper that we have yet to complete. We will get around to that eventually. But for now, I bid you adieu. This episode's gone long enough, and I will see you next time.